En el centro de la pampa vive un pimiento. Sol y viento pa' su vida, sol y viento. Sol y viento pa' su vida, sol y viento.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Patrick Barnard. Bienvenue à la 133e édition du Piment. Hello, I'm Patrick Barnard. Welcome to the 133rd edition of the Pimento Report. We're here in the Technopark region of Montreal again for the Pimento Report. Behind me, what you see in the distance is a lot of cut wood. Where was it cut? In a vital nesting area for birds, among them herons. En arrière, vous voyez une coupe. C'est dans une région qui est très valable pour les oiseaux. There's going to be a press conference this morning about the environmental issues here. This cut is being done for the Réseau Express Métropolitain. Cette coupe, c'est fait pour le REM, le Réseau Express Métropolitain. Il y aura une conférence de presse prochainement sur toutes les questions qui sont soulevées par ces actions. So we're going to see a press conference soon, and that's what we're going to film. Let's look at it now.
Les espèces menacées doivent être protégées. La loi le dit. The least bird turn has been nesting here for at least 3 years. So there is proof that this is critical habitat. Le gouvernement fédéral doit agir pour protéger. C'est nos terres. Ça nous appartient à nous. Là, il suffit de savoir comment protéger les terres fédérales, au moins ça. Et pour protéger les terres fédérales, il y a quelques options. Il y a la création d'un parc national urbain. Il y a déjà eu un précédent canadien avec la protection du bassin de la rivière Rouge à Toronto. Un parc fédéral urbain.
David Fletcher of the Green Coalition, why are you here this morning?
Because I think this is a real travesty. I think that this should never have happened. Given the choices, the priority should have been placed on protecting the marsh and also the forested area behind me. And you know, the fact that this is taking place before October, the deadline for birds, you know, the Migratory Birds Act, is just unseemly haste.
Lisa Mintz, it's the 12th of September. We're out here at the Technopark area. There's cut wood in the background and some equipment. What is going on here?
This is a green heron nesting site, and it is being cut down to make room for the construction of a tunnel underneath the wetlands for the REM.
For the Réseau Express Métropolitain?
Yep.
Okay. You're in the Green Coalition, you're in a number of environmental groups. What is the view of the environmental movement about this activity here and the tunnel going underneath the marshes?
Well, I mean, it's unacceptable. First of all, we don't believe that the REM should happen at all, but if it did, this place here is a very, very important area. If it was moved over like two streets, it would not be interfering with all of this wildlife. There's 30 species of birds that use this area and nest here, and when they come back next year, they will have no homes.
Lisa Mintz told me that these woods are important areas, nesting area, for example, for herons. Quite a few species use these woods.
Absolutely, Patrick, and you know, herons will nest high up in trees, right? And
what kind of trees are those that
we've got behind us are, from what I can see, based on the texture of the bark, they're mostly ash trees, and that would be the character of the trees around here. They like wet ground, and that's what I'm seeing there.
They're ash trees, which they probably are, how many would you say have been lost so far?
Oh my golly. Several hundred at least that I can make out. I would say between 100 and 200. I'm just sort of guessing.
Why is this happening?
Well, the KS, who has who is the private company, private sort of company, which is taking care of this REM project, has basically carte blanche to do whatever they like. They were actually passed a law which allows them to do things like the old train companies used to be able to do, which is appropriate land, expropriate land, appropriate land, build in places that other people aren't allowed to build in. It's very, very sad. They've done no environmental studies. They've done no climate tests on this thing, and everybody's really afraid of them.
All of that sounds very undemocratic.
It is extremely undemocratic. There are lots of parts of this project that are against the Charbonneau Commission.
Monsieur Green, quelle est la position du Parti Vert sur le réseau express métropolitain?
Oui. Alors, on a regardé le projet. Le constat qu'on a fait, que ce n'est pas un projet pour alléger l'étalement urbain, c'est un projet qui va augmenter l'étalement urbain. On a affaire à un État dans un État avec CPDQ à Franc. Essentiellement, ils avancent, peu importe les partis. Je suis un peu déçu de la position de Projet Montréal qui semble pencher pro-REM de ce temps-ci sans proposer des améliorations. Je sais qu'à l'intérieur de Projet Montréal, il y a des gens qui sont anti-REM. Dans sa forme actuelle,
now, you've watched Montreal lose its natural spaces over the last 35 to 40 years.
Oh, even more, Patrick. You know, going back much longer, going back to the 1960s when I started teaching, this process has been going on inexorably.
Now, does this remind you of what has gotten us into so much trouble? Is this very familiar, this destruction?
This is a familiar mindset at work here. It hasn't changed. One would think that the viewpoints of our leaders and our corporate leaders would have changed over the last 50 years. There have been a lot of warnings. There have been a lot of published, credible documentation from the United Nations, from organizations that really understand what they're talking about, warning about this assault, absolute assault on the environment.
This is
piece by piece. It's death by a thousand cuts.
So this is an example of destruction of biodiversity.
Absolutely it is. And, you know, our economy, our way of life depends on the integrity of an environment that seems to count for nothing in the minds of the people that propagate these kind of things.
En el centro de la pampa vive un pimiento. Sol y viento pa' su vida, sol y viento, sol y viento pa' su vida.